Namaste, my dear friends. In this series of videos, we are discussing the future of yoga, and an important discussion that comes in modern yoga is the narcissistic manner in which people approach yoga. So many people think that yoga is for their body to become slimmer, to become more attractive, to become more flexible. And that is the narcissistic approach that they tend to take. It's all about them and their body. And that's why you see this expression of it on Instagram, on Facebook, and other social media of people doing all these wonderful postures against the waterfall, against the sunset, to show how great they are. Yoga teaching is exactly the opposite of this. Yoga is asking us to reduce the ego and become more humble and more sensitive so that we receive the capacity to connect with ourselves, with others, and with the universe. The moment we become very narcissistic, it's a very egoistic principle. We build a big wall around us where we think we are so great and others are not so great. We think that we are more important than others. This includes not only other people, but also other things like other animals, other plants, and things like that. And that's why in this year, we have faced the biggest crisis that the world has ever seen, the coronavirus, which is basically because we have not honored nature as it should be honored. So the concept of narcissistic approach to yoga will lead to the downfall of not just yoga, but also of humanity. We are going to kill ourselves because we are so proud. Yoga teaches us exactly the opposite, reduce the ego. So many times, Patanjali in the Yoga Sutra says that the concept of asmita, the ego, is a klesha, that which hurts. And the more we are dependent on the ego, the more suffering we will have. And that's why yoga must not be practiced in that form where we are doing it just for the body, where we are trying to buy yogic clothes so that we look attractive, or yogic mats and yogic tattoos, and approach yoga in that way. That is also very culturally inappropriate, because some of these gods and goddesses or these mantras that we have are very sacred and they cannot just be tattooed on any part of the body. So that's another bad thing as a consequence of this narcissistic attitude towards yoga. So avoiding all that, we take a very humble spiritual approach. That would be much, much better and much more useful. I sincerely hope that we will all learn from the suffering that we have endured, not only individually but also collectively this year, and hope that we will surrender our ego, not necessarily our will, but surrender our ego and approach yoga with less ego and more humility. That would be great for the future of yoga. Please reflect about it, my friends, and I will do the same, I promise you. Namaste.